Are you serious? Are you serious, folks? What? There is an unbelievable situation developing right now as the solar winds on the sun have reached unprecedented speeds of a biblical proportion. And you won't believe it as there's a massive hole in the atmosphere of the sun allowing these incredible solar stream winds to come toward the earth. Let me put a shout out real quick though before I break this down. This is a prophecy alert and we can find it even in the Bible. But let me put out a shout real fast. Guys, Rate Family, that's www.ratefamily.com, a great, great company. You see, look, death of the family can be very hard, folks, for all of us. I mean, and it's coming, okay? And unfortunately, we have to deal with it sooner or later. All of us will have to leave behind, final expenses such as funeral costs, medical bills, and other debts. In fact, the average funeral loan is somewhere between $8,000 and $9,000 per person. And if you have no insurance, when you die, this can leave your loved ones with a huge bill to deal with, and no one wants that. So take control of your family's destiny today and have the satisfaction that you will leave them financially secure and not with this debt. Go to www.ratefamily.com. That's www.ratefamily.com. And ask for Eric, because I tell you, there's two members of my online church, Ed and Suzanne, that live up in Michigan. They called. They got Eric, and Eric was wonderful. He kept answering every question. He worked through the whole situation and got them the greatest deal that he could. Unbelievable customer service and friendly and very helpful. Matter of fact, they'll give you a free quote. They can select the best plan to fit your needs and your budget. Don't forget, folks, burial expenses, very easy to budget your way through this. Some people even pay as low as $36 a month. It depends on your age and situation. But please, go to www.ratefamily.com. That's www.ratefamily.com. Or just call this number, 1-855-919-RATE. That's 855-919-RATE. Let me tell you what's going on, guys. Prophecy alert. The sun is absolutely out of control. Here's what we're finding out. The solar winds right at this moment are blowing 718 kilometers per second. What? That is unreal. That is off the charts. That is insane. No, I've seen it this high before. I've even seen it a little higher. During solar maximums, not solar minimums. This is way out of character, way out of whack. And it means the sun is something, seriously, it's very unstable. Something's happening. Some gravitational pull. Is it Planet X? Is it Nibiru? Is it planet number 9? Or the dwarf star? Or a binary system? Or the goblin? Or wormwood, which is what the Bible calls it? Or whatever you want to do with this. But something biblical is going on with the signs of the second coming of Christ. I'm telling you, this could be a sign of the end of the world. And here's what they're saying. This fast-moving stream of solar winds are hitting the Earth's magnetic field right now. First contact has produced already a G1 class geomagnetic storm. Massive auroras will be seen tonight in Montana, North Dakota, Minnesota, and other portions of North America. There's no doubt about it. It may be spectacular, but it is because we are being inundated with radiation, with UV rays, with cosmic rays of a biblical proportion. And there's even scripture about this happening in the book of Revelation, chapter 16, of the signs of the end times. The Bible says in verse 8, I'm in Revelation 16, 8, and the fourth angel poured out his vial upon the sun, and power was given to him to scorch men with fire. And men were scorched with great heat and blasphemed the name of God, which had power over these plagues, and they repented not to give him glory. And the fifth angel poured out his vial upon the seat of the beast, and his kingdom was full of darkness, and they gnawed their tongues for pain. and blaspheme the God of heaven because of their pains and their sores, and repented not of their deeds. Folks, this is what happens when you get overexposed to such incredible solar winds. Right now, it's a deadly, deadly killer. People don't even realize it. And it's not just the sun that's acting so unstable, but apparently this binary system, Nibiru, Planet X, call it what you want, put this gravitational pull that NASA is even admitting is happening in that little green file. We've talked about it in the Heavens Are Shaking DVD that you can get with the four DVD series. The pole shift, it looks like it's taking place already. We know it is. And while this, the dead birds, the dead fish, the dead cows, the mass animal deaths, there's no question. The erratic weather, the extreme weather conditions, the massive heat waves this year, insane hailstorms, the lightning bolts, the thunder, the bolts are explosive and deadly. Charged particles are littering space as the dust comes settling upon the earth. All these things are happening with the gravitational pull of Planet X. Now, In the book, The Worlds in Collision by Emmanuel Velikovsky, he told us this was going to happen, that the sun would begin to crack and pull apart. We know that the Peruvians talked about massive tsunamis that are coming. The last time that this Planet X went by 3,600 years ago, the Peruvians wrote about it. The Mayans wrote about it. The Incans wrote about it. The North American Indians talked about it. The Asians talked about it. The Pharaohs and the hieroglyphics wrote about it. The Torah, the Bible, the Book of Exodus, the 10 plagues of Egypt. We know it. And so Emmanuel Velikovsky told us it'd be like liquid fire would come up on the earth. And then there's, of course, Jeremiah Stitchin. He's got some weird beliefs and some wild things, but he was correct about at least one thing, the binary system's effects on the planet. Now we've got NASA, secret files, secret scientific information seeping out of the bowels of the NASA, and we're beginning to acquire this information. And I've got the Bible in front of me with all of this info from the scientists being confirmed in the Word of God. Folks, we're living in the last days. Jesus said in Luke 21:25, he said there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars, and distress of nations with perplexity, the sea, the waves roaring, and men's hearts have failed them for fear, for looking after those things coming upon the earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And then shall we see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. When these things begin to come to pass, he said, look up, lift up your head. Your redemption is drawing nigh. There's going to be men gnawing their tongues, scorching them with the heat and the radiation and the cancers. And it's going to get, and they will not repent. We're in the end of the world. We're coming to the end of the world. Are you saved? Give your life to Jesus Christ. We are running out of time. We don't know the day. I'm not saying I know the day or the hour, because nobody does. Jesus said that. But we can see the signs of the end times. Dead birds, dead fish, dead cows. Hosea chapter 4, verse 1 through 3. The signs are everywhere. Are you saved?